last night in like that, in that one March Madness game where the ball got stuck above the above the backboard, and so one of the cheerleaders lifted one of the other ones up to like get up and reach it. It was wild.
Said about it being cooler up here. It's hot. It's getting hotter.
When that breeze
Keeps going. Yeah.
Yeah. Once that breeze gives away, it's all back. You're reminded that you're in Texas still.
Oh my god. They gotta hurry up. It's getting closer and closer.
Take a damn picture.
Like once it hits 11, everyone's gonna check their phone if we're not on the board. You know.
I feel like the speech is going to just get cut short. I don't even care about that, man. Like, what's he going to tell me? We're never going to tell us, though.
Yeah, right.
The real key is wherever they put the board, just to see whoever's closest grabs it.
Yeah, is it just like a mad dash to the board? How does it work?
Yeah.
That's...
From what I've heard, from what I can tell, it's a mad dash.
Oh, man. I thought there was going to be just like a bunch of boards and there'd be like maybe, you know, 20 per...
No, there's one board, two sides.
Oh, God.
I feel like people are just going to check their phones. There's going to be like a decent number. There's like... And you can get the paper after.
Yeah, I'll probably just wait a second.
So if you brought anybody with the football pads, now's time to break them out.
I'm like, the urge to just glance at your phone and just see.
It's not the same.
Yeah, it's not.
I like very specifically did not wear my like Apple Watch for that.
Yeah, I turned my notifications off and
I was like, that's not going to happen.
Families, it's wonderful to have you here. We're going to get started right now. I'm Andrea Stoller. I'm Senior Associate Dean of Student Affairs. I'm here with my team, Dr. Morrow and Dr. Poitras. We are very, very excited to share this day with you. I'm glad to have Dr. Monroe. And first, we're going to have Dr. Klopman, President and Executive Dean.
Speak. Whatever. I have many titles. Hey, everybody. Well, this is fantastic. This is the first time we've had anything face-to-face for quite a while. And it's so exciting to think that you guys have actually gotten through what has got to be the most difficult medical school experience in the history of mankind. So congratulations to all of you for actually getting this far. So congratulations to all of you. Now, I do want to say something about, you know, match day, because I remember it was like it was yesterday. Very terrifying. You have no idea where you're going. And I want to remind you, it's called match day. It's not called selection day. You're not selecting where you want to go. You're getting matched to a place that wants to have you there. And so this is a really important to think about. You're gonna, wherever you go, wherever you open that envelope, people are on the other side are excited about your joining them. And it's not important where you match, it's important how you do where you match. So wherever you match, you know, if you don't say it was your first, second, or third choice, wherever it is, that's the place you're destined to go. And you should be very happy because people are really excited about your coming to them. Between you and me, and just the 500 of us, my closest personal friends, you know, I had my choices. I didn't get my first choice. And my wife, who's the dean of the Duke Medical School, didn't get her first choice. But we both ended up in the same, place, which kind of helped us. Anyway, oh shit. It's probably good you didn't hear the last part. Anyway, congratulations. Whenever you open that envelope, just be really happy. You've done a great job, and congratulations to you and the families in particular, because you finally have a kid who's got a job.
Thank you, Dr. Klopman. Now I'm going to introduce my partner, Dr. Poitras, to say a few words.
Good morning. It's a big day, and I know that I speak for all of the School of Medicine deans and faculty and staff, whether it be in student affairs or curriculum or simulation lab or the assessment and evaluation programs, to say congratulations and how proud we are of you and the honor it has been to support you along the way. From John Rapp's Thursday News to the fact that some of you may have gotten a wake-up call for a test that you were a little bit late for that you had studied all night for by one of our assessment faculty. We are all very proud of you. This is your day. You've worked so hard to get to this point. Today is the day of what's next. And soon you will learn where what next is. I ask you to remember just one thing. Carry the culture of the BCM student with you. You are incredibly hardworking and industrious. Along the way, you have been influenced by family, by friends, by significant others, by patients, by faculty. But just as much as they have influenced you, you too have influenced us. That energy and positivity and pushing forward is palpable in all of you. Honestly, I experience it every single day in the office, and it's what motivates me to be better. So just as you became de facto mentors when you started your second year for all of the new first years, you will now be a mentor to your peers and the students that you will be teaching. So be positive, be bold, and be the change agent for excellence. Be that culture of BCM wherever you go. Congratulations.
And now I'd like to welcome Justin Vincent, your president.
Hey everyone, it is showtime. Look, I'm so happy to see you all here and to get to share one of the most monumental steps in our training so far. Listen, I feel the anticipation, the excitement, the nerves, the cranial nerves, 2 through 12, bilaterally intact. Anyway, as we're approaching 11, I recommend that we all pause and take a deep breath. Inhale. Don't forget to exhale. Perfect. Repeat that as needed. Just remember, you're here. All is good. You got it. The last few years of studying, exams, clinical rotations, gallery walks, on top of freezes, floods, and an ongoing pandemic have all prepared us way more than we can ever imagine. The adaptability and perseverance are incredibly inspiring. Because of that and more, we are all better prepared for any unexpected plot twist that life is going to throw at us. From lemons, we make lemonade. And I'm so proud and so impressed by all the lemonade that you've made and all the pancakes that you have eaten. This is a big day, but for us, we take the training that we got at Baylor College of Medicine and we'll take that wherever we go. For some of us, that's going to be far off lands like Ohio, Florida, ooh. And or you're just going to stay here in the neighborhood and you can probably go ahead and hit renew on that lease. So with that in mind, I just wanted to thank everyone that's here today. Thank you to the faculty, to the staff, to the deans, to the institutional leadership, to the family, the friends, the significant others, the pets, whoever invented Anki. We all thank you. We could not be here without you. It just keeps us in mind that the most important people that have influenced here and got us to where we are our patients. And those patients will be the people that we advocate for, care for, and just kind of do everything that we want to do in medicine. So with that, congratulations to us all. Very exciting time. Good luck. You'll kill it. It'll be a great time. And congratulations. Yeah.
It's really amazing. It's really remarkable to see everybody here today. I am incredibly proud of what you've accomplished. You've all come through medical school during an unprecedented time. The tremendous losses and also the amazing scientific gains that have come with COVID have had a profound impact on your experiences of becoming a physician. But you've not only overcome, you've blossomed. Your initiative, drive, and creativity helped our community cope with the pandemic. You supported our frontline workers and then you became them. You rolled with the punches, accepted the unexpected with grace and maturity, and made the best of difficult situations. You are better equipped because of your experiences. You are stronger people because of what you've endured. Continue to use this for good. I want to thank our world-class affiliate hospitals who've provided the foundation of clinical excellence in which you've grown into the physicians you're about to become. We are so fortunate that our hospital leadership continues to ensure that education remains a priority. I'd like to thank our amazing faculty for serving as role models and providing their knowledge and support to all of you, and to Dean Christner for her leadership. And most importantly, as Justin said, our thanks to our patients, all the patients that you cared for, who are our most important teachers. What is written in that envelope will be the next step on your pathway to your goal. Although the path may take unexpected turns and twists and might not be exactly what you'd planned or even hoped for, you've learned that you can adjust. You can make the road to which you have matched the best one to get you to where your goal is. And you can learn, as you have over these last few years, that you're better for it. It is a great privilege to be a physician, to have the permission to enter the lives of others in the most intimate of ways, and in that way to serve. Thank you for letting me travel alongside you along this pathway to that goal. Thanks to our student leaders, Justin and Courtney, who are going to help pull those sheets down. Thank you to our student affairs team. Thank you to all of your families who supported you along the way. Thank you for being here, and thank you for supporting us and allowing us the privilege of working with your students. And so with that, we're going to start counting down, and there are two sides to each board. And this is when we start the countdown.
Okay, everyone, just like Dr. Stolar said, there are two boards and envelopes are on both sides of each board. We have people who have signs, so if all of my sign holders can hold your signs up. A through FA is on this side of this board, FE through K on this side, then L through RA on this side, and then R through Z on the other side. So if you guys can start gathering.
Six, five, four, three,